So today's bite-sized base hack is all about reflective surfaces. Now, you'll be able to hear this when I change rooms. Right now, I'm in the main living room, and I have more reflective surfaces in here than I would like to have. This is a wood floor, and I'm going to show you what I've got down here. And by the way, yes, the dog does help absorb some of the sound. but this surface here, ideally, I would have this entirely carpeted. The entire thing would be carpeted because that would reduce the first reflection that comes off. So first reflection is when it comes off the speaker, it's that first bounce before it gets to you. And that really causes some noise and some issues. But this is less of an issue for people that have more textiles in their home than people that have bare floors. So if you have tile, wood floor, things like that, you know, just bare concrete. Some people have that, which is a really cool look. I like it. But the thing is it reflects sound. And reflective sound, you know, there's a lot of companies really, you know, talk about how great reflective sound is. And honestly, it's more of an issue to be dealt with rather than something to be capitalized on. That's one of the reasons I'm a big fan of these elevation speakers here, because they fire the sound directly rather than bouncing it up off the ceiling. I'm not a big fan of the whole ceiling bounce thing. So, you know, and that's true of a lot of other brands too. Man, I can't get this thing. There we go. Well, sort of. Anyway, I'm going to move into the RV project I've got going on. It's really hot out there, so I wanted to get the majority of it done here. But I also wanted you to hear my voice in this room. I've had a lot of people give me a hard time because I don't have the amount of acoustic treatment that I should have in this room. And I agree, I just had different plans and things like that I was shooting for. But yes, there's a lot of echo in this room, and believe me, I noticed it right away once I started shooting it in the RV. And fortunately, the RV does have a very good acoustic signature. It's not very echoey in there, which is great. So we'll go ahead and move into the RV now, and you can hear the difference in my voice. Okay, so now we're in the RV, and I just want to give you an idea of the difference of the sound in here, just the sound of my voice, as I've got all this fabric in here. So the ceiling itself is fabric, so it's a lot different than the house. The house, it's got a regular ceiling, definitely not a fabric ceiling. And then we've got carpeted floor here. And so, and by the way, this is going to be quick and I'll show you why. It's pretty warm in here and a lot warmer than I can normally tolerate. So it's going to be kind of quick. But it's really, the sound in here, it echoes so much less. And that's just because of all the textiles, all of these fabrics and things. They all make a difference. You know, it just dampens the sound, and it's just, you know, you can hear it in my voice. My voice is clearer. It's not echoey. So if you're looking at the benefits of putting down, you know, just a rug, if you've got a hard floor, just putting down a rug can really make a big difference. If you're, you know, doing a home theater and you're trying to figure out, well, should I do tile or should I do carpet? I mean, to me, it's a no-brainer. Carpet all the way. Thick pad if you can. Any way you can, you know, and then there's, beyond that, you know, there's room treatments, you know, you can do the foam panels, all that stuff. It all pays off. But I just wanted to, you know, show you guys the difference here in the way the room is set up. But the only hard surfaces I have in here is like the wall surface and then, you know, the cabinets and things like that. The rest is all, you know, very, I don't know, it all absorbs the sound a lot better. So that's just kind of where I'm at. Sorry if I'm the video's all shaky, but I just want to show you what I'm dealing with and kind of what's going on. Anyway, that's this week's bite-sized bass hack. We're just dealing with, you know, reflective surfaces. You want to avoid them as much as possible and really focus more on textiles and things like that. So anyway, thanks for watching. If you haven't watched the rest of the videos, you can check out the bite-sized bass hacks playlist. And it's all short, easily digestible hacks like this to improve your home theater. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate the support. I appreciate the likes, the comments, and all that. It really makes a big difference. So thanks for watching, and please subscribe.